guys, it's Ileane from IleaneSmith.com. And in today's live video, I want to show you how you can add a vignette to your YouTube live stream. You can make that vignette using PicMonkey, and it's a free online tool. So before I do that, let me give you an example of what the vignette looks like. You notice that it just gives a little extra shadow around the edges of the video. And in this particular vignette, I also added my logo with a transparent background. So now I'm going to show you another example of a YouTuber that's using this vignette. And I'm going to show you step by step how to create this vignette in PicMonkey. Smith.com. And in today's video, I want to show you how to make this really cool vignette, just like the one you see here being used by my friend Gideon Shalwick. This question actually came up in one of Gideon Shalwick's YouTube live events. And see how there's just this little hint of gray around the edge. It's called a vignette. And Gideon's been doing some fantastic live events, very engaging events, and we have been having conversations in the chat box. And someone asked, how did he make the vignette? And I said, I can show you how to do that in PicMonkey. So I'm going to show you right now. So over on PicMonkey, guys, first thing you want to do is hover over design. You're going to go to custom. Now, you can size this however you want. Since we're going to use this on YouTube, let's use 1280 by 720. Now, here's what's important, guys. It already gives you a blank white canvas, but we don't want white. We want transparent. And we're going to click apply. See how I clicked off transparent there? And this little checkerboard symbol, that's like the universal symbol in any image editing tool. Whenever you see this checkerboard, you know that it's transparent. So now we want to go over to the effects. And PicMonkey has all these pre-made effects. The one we want to use is dark edges. Now, it's already set up. And this would be great, except I've tested this a few times and it looks kind of dark. So I want to fade it out. Maybe change the intensity a bit and adjust the size. And now hit apply. Now, one important step, guys, when you save this, it must be saved as a PNG because a JPEG is not transparent. So I'm just going to name this vignette for YouTube. Save it. I'm just going to save it right on my desktop so we can find it easily. So now we're done with this. I just want to give you an example of how it looks. So I'm going to take an existing YouTube thumbnail. And in this case, guys, what we would do is we will go to overlay, because now we want to overlay that vignette on top of the thumbnail. And you can resize it. And it just gives that little hint, that little extra dimension to just make your image pop. It just gives that little extra dimension. Just make your image pop just a little more. And if you feel like it's still just a little too dark, you can fade out that overlay just so it gets right where you want the mood of your thumbnail to be. So now in this case, we don't have to save it as a PNG. When we upload this to YouTube, it's up to you. You can save it as PNG or JPEG. So here's the before look
And here's after with the vignette applied. So I hope you found this tutorial helpful, guys. Please subscribe. I'm always making tutorials. If you have any questions, any requests, just let me know in the comments, or you can head over to ileanesmith.com.